High School Crossfire is brought to you by Skin Guard.
With Skin Guard, we are protected.
Skin Guard is for everyone.
If you've just tuned in, it's never too late. We're still debating right here on the High School Crossfire. It's St. Joseph College, Libby, and Kawempe Muslim School. The topic is, this house believes that students should not study in shifts. Welcome back.
Well, thank you very much. I'm speaking, I'm Paul Uchan Morris, the chairman of the Building Club Libby College. I wanted to praise in live testimony, say, teaching in shift in Libby College right now, we have 1,200 students. 1,200 students. Just recently, last year, the best student in A level got 19 points. It happens only in very computer, which their students were very many. In here, you may not even handle a computer in your hand. And I have no doubt that boy was going to get 20 points. When we were in senior five, we were taught just like that, there's no shame. We used to get F9 in computer, but right now in senior six, we are getting distinctions because we are being taught in shape, practical. This is life testimony. I need you to know this. Now, looking at this, we shall find out that those days, the population in the Ibi College was few. We used to get 98 first grade in all level. But these days, we find that in a year we exist more than could be 190 candidates in all level. And the number of first grade is reducing to 57, from 98 to 99 to 57. Just because there's laxity, students behind, the backbenchers, they're not to concentrate. The teachers are not giving them what? The gap of being focused to them. Because you see, students are very mean in a class. There are more than 80 students. This is unrealistic. We need shift. Therefore, allow me to say, when we are giving some problem, we should know that we should give a long run and a short run. When they are building schools, we should know that in the short run, we should be doing shift. I rest in my case.
Thank you very much. My name is Ambu Shamik from Kawempe, and I hereby stand here supporting the motion saying that students should not be slowed in what shifts. Hereby saying that in most cases, the schools we have been in, all of us, most of us in, I'm sure all over the world, all over the country, in Asia, as they say, the parameters. In most cases, even the schools that perform very well, most of them, they don't teach in what? Double shifts. We very well know that. I'm trying to say that in most cases, teachers, before they go in for lessons, teach their students. Most of them get some time to prepare for the what? For the lesson. But if it's a double shift, in most cases, teacher is going to teach in the morning, he has a triple lesson, and realize that again, he has to teach another class in the what? The afternoon. The child will not get enough time to prepare for the next what? The next lesson. He will either be tired. So in most cases, realize that the child will just go there to cover up for the lesson. So that the teacher told, just cover up. In most cases, that's why I'm going to say that it's better for us to adopt the what? The single shift. Because in real life, all of us know that even the best performing schools right now in Uganda, I'm sure the best time, even the best quality, I'm sure none of the schools that teaches the double shift is the what? The amongst the top 50, I'm very sure. Because all of you know that you read newspapers every day, that even the best, first, second, third, all of them in the world, single shifts.
Thank you once again. I want to promote the message at St. Joseph College, IB, for your research and the time and the love you have for debate. I'm so happy for Kawempe. Last time you were this, but today you really were. You raised me, I'm so happy about you, I'm so proud to have it, because last time I watched your debate was really not good. To me, I almost cried, but today I'm so happy that I have speakers. Tomorrow I'm going to stand in Parliament and to advise this nation and take it forth. I just have a few comments from you, your first speaker. You came here to read for us notes. I can go to the computer and read all those notes you're reading here. The reason why you come here to debate is because you're chosen to debate is to inform us, even those who don't understand, those who cannot read, can get what you're saying. So next time when you come to debate, please understand the resolution, understand what you understand your notes, then come here and inform us. So some of us don't even get what you, because you're reading, you bored me really. So next time, no. Okay?
Thank you so much, the debaters. From this morning, I think this has been a highly contested debate round. So I must say that your argumentation at this level was very good. I must say that. However, the debate came down to one single line of argument. The affirmative want to change the status quo. The status quo is some schools in Uganda are studying in shifts. The negative team is saying, no, we want to maintain the status quo altogether. So I thought the biggest burden of the affirmative one was one, show us why we need to change the status quo and how to change the status quo and perhaps the benefits. From the case of the affirmative, I really felt the first speaker, you did not do a fair job in directing your team in giving them a line of argument to follow. So I really feel the argument began to come in the second speech at the end. The second speaker at the end, that's when he hinted on source of funding and buying land, which was the core of your argument. Altogether, the negative team, however, I felt that the negative team did a fair job in trying to defend why we need the shifts and why the change that the affirmative team is proposing cannot work, especially in the last speech about the money that comes with strings attached, and even the question of in the transition, where do the students go? So I feel that was the biggest line of argument. So for that, that's my largest observation. And lastly, listening. Debaters, please listen. I know when you come to the debate round, you have your prepared speech. But remember, you have an opponent. Pay attention to your opponent's speech, because from there you can get more valuable arguments. Thank you so much.
Burdens. Your biggest burden is refutation, the negative side. Your biggest burden is proof. Assuming you're debating your reasons why, and they're debating their reasons why, and there is no any clash, you're not responding, you're not largely penetrating your case, refutation wouldn't have any debate, would simply have a discussion in this room. So largely, the reason why there is a burden of proof and burden of refutation is to make sure there is a clash in the debate, is to make sure you penetrate their case and debate their case largely, to penetrate it down. So next time, learn how to realize that it is actually a burden on your side. Therefore, the winner of today's debate is, since it was a very tight debate, the decision wasn't unanimous, but still there was a decision made. The negative side. The negative side.
Now I'm coming to the winner's side, all the way from Gulu. It's actually a good thing they won. Honestly, how do you guys feel about your win? How excited are you about it?
Well, we are some kind of excited though. The first round we were some kind of messed up because we never knew much about it, but later on we gained the courage and we the guys are trying. Yeah, we're trying to move on and we shall see ourselves.
So anyway, even if you won in this particular debate, you know, maybe there's some pointers you picked up. What could those be?
As in writing my burdens, I did not pick up my burdens properly, and as in I did not refute the other people's case properly. Yeah, that's all.
So he learned how to refute. Yes. How about you?
This debate here, the last one actually, I managed to do my best. Yeah, I played my role as a third speaker. Although in the first one, never happened the way I wanted. But there's a great change.
Yeah. So they didn't do so well in the first round, but the second round, they definitely took it. These are the three honorables. Hey guys, this time no one's crying, so that's an improvement.
Well, losing is part of life. We shall cope up with that. Maybe next time, next year, never know. Shall make it.
So this is the end of the road for them, but you know, keep debating. All right, any word to, you know, people who are watching, people who are rooting for you? Because my producer was actually rooting for you. He said you won in spirit, so.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I won in spirit, and that's the fact. But, okay, anyway, I don't have a lot to say. All I can say is, bye.
I'm sad. What about you? You look so tough, huh? Like you're holding in those manly tears. It's okay, cry. It's a safe space.
Actually, all I have to say is I'm really happy. because compared to what the judges told us last time and what they've said today, we've really improved by a big deal. So I hope we continue debating and make our team stronger come next year. Bye-bye.
All right, so they didn't win, but they are the most improved. So it's nice to look at the silver lining and, you know, take something home. At the end of the day, they got some fun goodies from Skin Guard. So it's not such a huge loss, right? Anyway, it's all right here, High School Crossfire, right on Urban TV.
High School Crossfire was brought to you by Skin Guard.
With Skin Guard, I'm protected.
Skin Guard.